It's very quiet, so you'll hear them perfectly.
Good morning, your excellency.
Good morning. How are you today?
Good morning. We're doing very well. We've got some very excited students to chat with you. So I'm going to turn them over to the stars of the show. They're going to introduce themselves, but being with us today.
Great. Thank you.
I'm Drew Robert Rail. I'm in 10th grade.
I'm sorry, I cannot hear anything.
Go ahead. Can you ask your question?
They were just introducing
me. Ask your question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Look almost like yelling. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, try again.
What do you do as Archbishop?
How do I?
A little bit closer to the computer.
Yes, thank you.
What do you do as Archbishop?
Why am I an Archbishop?
What do you do as Archbishop?
Oh, what I do? Okay, that's a very good question. Well, I guess the first thing I try to pray every day, you know, and especially pray for all the people in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. It has three counties, Los Angeles, Ventura, and Santa Barbara. So every day I get up in the morning and I spend some time in prayer, and then I try to say Mass every morning. So I pray for all of you in the morning. Then besides that, I'll try to help people as much as I can through the parishes of the Archdiocese, through Catholic schools. Catholic schools are very important for me and my ministry because I know that you enjoy your Catholic school, and there are so many kids in Catholic school that's very important for me to support Catholic schools. Then we have many more ministries in the Archdiocese. So, and I try to help people to come closer to God. So that's my main mission as an Archbishop.
What do you do if somebody's being mean to you?
With somebody what?
If somebody's being mean to you.
Oh, well, first of all, I forgive that person. I ask for the grace to be able to forgive that person. Because that's what Jesus did, and I try to imitate Jesus in my daily life. So when somebody says something that I don't like or is mean, as you said, then I follow the example of Jesus. And as you know, this year we are celebrating the year of mercy, and mercy is forgiveness. So I forgive, and then after that, I pray for that person. So I think it is important for us when we that something like that happens to make sure that that we pray for the person that is saying something that is not good for us. Okay?
Thank you for your time.
You're welcome. Thank you. Good morning. What is your name?
I'm Braden Arnold in third grade.
Okay. Why do you listen to the questions that translate to me? I can't hear anything.
You can ask your question and then I'll relay it over and the Archbishop will answer.
Do you like being an Archbishop?
She wondered if she could be an Archbishop.
Well, right now, all the bishops are priests. And the priests, as you know, are men. So, because Jesus wanted that to happen. So obviously the most important thing is not our role or function in society or in the church, but the most important thing is what is in our heart. like for me to be an archbishop, the most important thing is to be a saint, okay? And we all can be saints. So I think it is important for you to set the goal of your life to becoming a saint. And then you will be not just an archbishop, but even more than that, a saint, okay?
Do you have to travel a lot?
Do you have to travel a lot? That's a very good question, too. Yes, I have to travel a lot. First, in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, I go to all the different parishes, and as I said, I go to Ventura, I go to Santa Barbara, to Santa Maria, everywhere in the Archdiocese, San Pedro, Claremont, everywhere. But then I also have to travel in the United States, throughout the United States, because there are many meetings of bishops and invitations that I receive to speak in different places. So I have to travel inside the United States. Then I have to travel especially to Rome, because sometimes the archbishops have to be attending meetings and make reports to the Pope and the Vatican. But then last week, I had the blessing of being with Pope Francis. I went to Mexico during his apostolic trip to El Paso and Ciudad Juarez, and I consulted very much with him. So I personally don't like to travel. I like to be home because I enjoy being home. But for my job, I have to travel a lot. So I ask you prayers that I can have safe travels. Okay?
Thank you.
Thank you. I can get the names.
Go ahead. Let me know your name. Yes.
I am Ryan Rabowski, and I'm in fourth grade. Hi, I'm Abby Carfaro, and I'm
Ryan
in fourth
grade. And what is your name?
Abby Carfaro, and I'm in fourth grade.
Right, do I ask your question?
What's your favorite thing about being archbishop?
I want to know your favorite thing about being archbishop. They're a little easier to understand.
Okay. Thank you, Ryan, for your question. My favorite thing is first to celebrate Mass every day, because that's a beautiful grace and prayer that I have every day. I can, as a priest, I can celebrate Mass and be Christ on the altar. But then after that, what I like the most is just to go and be with people. Like today, as we are talking, I'm here at the Religious Education Congress. We have about 20,000 people here. And it's just great to be with so many people that are good Christians and trying to live by mercy and helping one another. So that's what I like the most.
What's your favorite book in the Bible and why?
That's a good question. I mean, my favorite book in the Bible, I like the whole Bible, but especially the Gospels, and I like especially the Gospel of Mark, because it really talks about the life of Jesus and what people were thinking about him, and how he talks about the humanity and the divinity of Jesus. Then I like a lot also the Acts of the Apostles. You know why? Because he talks about the first Christians. And I think it's a beautiful example of how we have to be Christians in the 21st century. So those two books, St. Mark's Gospel and the Acts of the Apostles, I like them a lot.
Thank you for your time. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
What are your names?
Hi, I'm Jack Norton.
Hi, I'm Hannah Munninger.
Okay. You have questions for me?
Do you want to be Pope one day?
That's an interesting question. He's asking me if I want to be a Pope. I don't think so. I think I'm happy being an Archbishop, and that's probably what God is asking me to do. So, but as I said, I was with Pope Francis last week, and he was very, very happy. And he sent his blessings to all of us here in the Archdiocese. And please keep Pope Francis in your prayers, okay?
What's your favorite prayer in the Bible?
My favorite prayer in the Bible? Well, obviously, the prayer that is very beautiful and I say every day is the Our Father. And the Our Father is a beautiful prayer that can help us understand that God is our Father. And He cares about each one of us. So I like that prayer a lot. But there are many other prayers that I like. I like, you know, the Hail Mary comes from the conversation of the Archangel Gabriel with our Blessed Mother. Then there is a beautiful prayer also, the sounds are beautiful, you know, there's one sound, that is Psalm 139, it also talks to us about how God cares about us every single minute of our lives. So, when you read the Bible, I think what you have to see and understand is that God is talking to you. It's amazing how God can talk to you. The all perfection, all beauty, He's talking to you personally. So make sure that you read the Bible every day. Okay?
Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Introduce yourselves. Say your name.
My name is Bennett Cromley. I'm in kindergarten.
Good. My name is Bennett, and I'm in kindergarten.
This is Bennett and Mai, and they're kindergartners.
Okay, great. Nice to meet you. And what are your questions?
So I think Bennett's question is, he wanted to know about the different garments or the different clothes you wear as the Archbishop. Do you have different things that make you different in terms of what you wear?
Well, sure. Thank you. That's a very good question. There are three things that we use. One is a ring. So we have a ring. I don't know if you can see it, but it's a ring that we have. Every bishop has a ring. So it's a sign of our commitment to God and to the church. Then we also have it's a mitre, I don't know how to describe it, it's like a hat that also talks to us about relationship with God. And then a crosier. Crosier is like a
staff
or like
a stick.
That talks to us about the fact that we are the good shepherds of the people where we live. So those three things are distinctive of an archbishop. Okay.
How did you choose your motto as archbishop?
Thank you for your question. I did because it's a beautiful phrase of the letter to the Hebrews in the Bible that talks about how we have to go with confidence to Jesus to obtain mercy, that we feel the love and mercy of God in our lives, and also as we are reflecting this year, to be merciful and forgiving to one another. So I like it a lot because it helps me to think of always every single moment of my life about Jesus, and also how much God loves me and each one of us. But the motto is, let's go with confidence to the throne of God to obtain mercy. Okay? Thank you for your questions.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
Aiden.
Aiden.
My name is Haven.
What's your question?
This is Haven and Aiden, and there are TKers, so they're the youngest students we have here at St. Mary's.
Great.
And Aiden, what's your question, Aiden?
Why do you have to pray?
That's a very good question. I have to pray because I know that God loves me, and I want to have a conversation with Him, like with your parents. Your parents love you, so you want to talk to them. Don't you?
Yeah.
And you want them to talk to you too. So that's what I have a prayer. It's a conversation with God. So it's true, I cannot see God, but I can talk to Him, and I know that He's listening to me. And that's the greatest thing on earth. You know, when you get home and probably having dinner and want to, you know, talk to your parents, when you see that they pay attention and listen to you, that's a great feeling. So that's what prayer is so important for us, that we can talk to God. And that's what I do.
Where's heaven?
Where is heaven? Where is... That's a good question. Well, heaven is whatever God is. So where God is, because heaven is basically the place where we are going to be with God forever and totally happy. You know, it's like, you know, Disneyland big time. So, yeah, I know that Disneyland is right here in Anaheim, but heaven is even much better and a bigger place and most beautiful place where we are going to have a lot of fun. Okay. You're welcome. Thank you. Have a great day. Good morning.
Hi, my name is Sydney Hyman. I'm in fifth grade. Hello, my name is Jack Garman, and I'm in fifth grade.
Wonderful. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Nice to meet you too. Okay. My question for you is, what do we as Catholics not do enough?
What do we as Catholics? Can you repeat?
What do we as Catholics not do enough?
Ah, okay. That's a good question. First of all, I think we need to remember that we do a lot of things. We do, prayers and helping other people. And so there are so many beautiful things that we as Catholics do. But then I think what we can do more is to share with other people the beauty of our faith. Because most people out there don't know anything about it. Sometimes because their parents didn't talk to them, or they were not raised in the Catholic faith or the values of the faith. So it's important for us to share with them how much God loves us, how He's present in our lives, how we can talk to Him, and He listens to us, and how He gives direction and meaning to our lives. So That's what we call missionary work or apostolic work. So I think that's what we can do better. Talk to people about God.
My question is, who is your favorite saint and why?
That's a good question. My problem is that I have too many. Obviously, I have a special devotion to Mary, our Blessed Mother, because she's the mother of Jesus and our mother. And I have entrusted my life and my ministry to Mary, our Blessed Mother. But then I have a special devotion to St. Joseph, because it's my patron saint. My name, Jose, is obviously Joseph in Spanish. So I have a special devotion to him. And I have many other saints, I met during my life a few saints. I met St. John Paul II. I met St. Jose Maria Escrivá, who was a priest from Spain. So I have devotion to them. I love the lives of the saints, because most of them were totally normal people, okay? Sometimes we think of the saints like, wow, this is something special or different. They were just like us. They went to school, they got their parents, and sometimes they were not happy, and they were a little rebellious or whatever, but now they are saints. So I think I try to reflect on the lives of the saints a lot. So, but Mary, our Blessed Mother, and St. Joseph are my favorite saints.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, good morning.
Good morning. My name is Logan Perez, and I am sixth grade.
And my name is Quinn Bowers, and I'm also in sixth grade.
Right.
Okay, so I've got one question for you. What's your favorite thing to do in your free time?
My favorite thing to do. Okay, got it. I like to play sports. I like all sports. I like to play basketball. I mean, I'm so old that it's not easy for me to play too many things anymore. But I like to play basketball. I used to play soccer a lot. I like to play tennis, or, you know, sports is my big thing. So that's what I enjoy a lot. You may know my team, a basketball team, is the LA Lakers. Nobody's perfect, so. And my football team is the Green Bay Packers.
Ooh, I like the Green Bay Packers too.
All right, go Packers.
Ooh, and I had a question for you too.
Yes.
How many priests are in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles?
Okay. Right now, there are about 1,200 priests in the Archdiocese. 500 of them, because the Archdiocese of Los Angeles is the largest Archdiocese in the country. We have about 5 million Catholics in the Archdiocese. The second one is the Archdiocese of New York, and they have about 2.5 million Catholics. So we are twice as large as New York. So we have about 1,200 priests. Of those 1,200 priests, about 500 are priests ordained for the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. And the other, like Father Preston at your parish, is a priest ordained for the Archdiocese. And then we have about 700 that are priests that belong to a religious order, like the Franciscans or the Jesuits or the Dominicans, all of those religious orders that are in the church. So we have a lot of priests that come and serve the people of the Archdiocese that really do not belong to the Archdiocese. That's what we need, many more priests for the Archdiocese. Right now we have about 84 seminarians for the Archdiocese. And this past year we ordained 8 new priests, and this coming year 9 new priests for the Archdiocese. So we need many more vocations, and I hope that we all reflect on the beauty and the gift of the priesthood and the meaning of our vocation in the church. Pray for priests, please.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Thank you.
No, thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Avery Shinaka and I'm in seventh grade.
Okay, nice to meet you.
You too. How did you know that you wanted to become Archbishop?
That's a very good question. How do I know that I wanted to become an Archbishop? Well, what I wanted to be was a priest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, because I felt when I was probably 14 or 15 that God was calling me to be a priest. Mm-hmm. And it took me a little while because then after high school I went to college, and when I finished college then I decided to go to the seminary. But that was the call that I had to be a priest. And God has blessed me with that gift of the priesthood. Then becoming a bishop or an archbishop is up to the Pope. So I was a priest in Texas, and then Pope John Paul II, now St. John Paul II, appointed me or asked me to be the a bishop in Colorado, Denver, Colorado. Then I was there for 4 years, and then after that, St. Pope St. John Paul II asked me to go to San Antonio, Texas, and be the Archbishop of San Antonio. And then, after 5 years over there, Pope Benedict asked me to become the Archbishop of Los Angeles. And I'm very happy to be the Archbishop of Los Angeles, because there are so many wonderful people in Los Angeles that it's a great joy for me to be here. So I really didn't want to be an archbishop, but God wanted me to do it. All right?
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you. Please pray for me.
Okay.
Good morning.
Hi. My name's Thomas Guerra. I'm in eighth grade. I go to St. Mary's.
I'm Chloe. I'm in eighth grade.
Good.
My question for you is, since we're graduating, we're going to high school. I want to know, is there anything that you recommend, like for kids, like 13, 14, like going into high school, what they should do to develop and maintain a better relationship with God and Jesus?
Sure. First of all, congratulations on your graduation. You are getting close to graduating, huh?
Yeah.
All right. That's great. What I recommend is two things for your faith. First is to read the Gospels, because we are Christians. So that means followers of Jesus Christ. So we got to know his life. And the way to do it is reading the Gospels. I mean, it takes 2 minutes. Just, you know, Google, or you have it in your iPhone or your device, and then you can read a little bit of the Gospels every day. That's the first thing. And the second thing is to pray every day. Those two things can make a big difference in your life, because then you get to know Jesus and you become friends with Jesus. And that's what Christian life is all about. So that would be my recommendation.
All right, and then my question is, how would you advise someone who is at a low time in their life to turn to God for help, even if they haven't spent much time with him before?
That's a very good question, because sometimes that happens to all of us, that we just get distracted. So what I recommend is just to trust God. maybe sometimes what helps us is to go to confession, because then we can talk to the priest, and the priest is going to welcome us. It's just like the parable in the gospel of the prodigal son. You know, he left and, you know, was not really behaving well. And then he came back and his father was waiting for him with his open arms and forgave him and organized a big celebration. That's what confession is all about. So what I recommend to those people is to trust God, that God is always forgiving us. And the best way to do it is going to confession. We call it also the sacrament of joy, because it's the joy of knowing that God is always there for us.
Okay. Right.
Great. All right. Thank you, Anna Grego. Congratulations. All right.
Thank you, Excellency, very much. We have a full schedule, so we appreciate your taking the time to be with us.
Absolutely. Thank you. You are in my prayers, and please pray for me.
Thank you. We will. Okay.
God bless. Okay. Bye now.
All right, guys. Excellent job.